Hi students, welcome back. Hi students, welcome back. Today we are going to discuss demand problems. So next problem number 23. So this problem is taken in KCET 2018. Okay. So a cyclotron's oscillator frequency is 10 MHz. And the operating magnetic field is 0.66 tesla. If the radius of its DC is 60 centimeter, then the kinetic energy of the proton beam produced by the oscillator. So this is the question. A cyclotron's oscillator frequency. Now frequency is given. So if it is equal to 10 megahertz, so 10 megahertz is converted into hertz. So 10 to the 4 of 6. So that is equal to 10 to the 4 of 6 H. The next magnetic field is H. So B is equal to 0.66 SR. If the radius of this R is equal to 60 centimeter, that is equal to 60 into 10 to the 4 of H. So plus 1 minus 1 cancel, this is equal to 0.6 meter. So then find out the kinetic energy. So K is equal to 5. So we know that. So what is the formula for radius? R is equal to W divided by 20. Okay. So now, so by using this one, B is equal to R divided by W. So therefore, kinetic energy K is equal to of M V square. So now of M into V. So V is equal to Q V square by R. V square is Q square. V square R square divided by M square, where M and cancel. So therefore kinetic energy K is equal to Q square V square R square divided by 2M. This is the value of the kinetic energy. Okay, so here you can substitute the value of kinetic energy Q is equal to, so we know that charge of electron. So what is the value of charge? So 1.6 into 10 to the 4 of minus 90 joule square into B. So B is equal to 0.66 joule square into R. So 0.6 joule square. So divided by 2 into mass of electron 9.1 into 10 to the 4 of minus 90. Okay. So here 1.6 into 1.6. So that means 2.56 into 10 to the 4 of minus 38. So input the, so 0.066. So 0.66 into 0.66. So 66 is 36. So another 39. Next to 693. So 0006. So 15. So 13.40, so that means 0.4356. So 0.4356 into, so 0.6 into 0.6. So that means 0.36. So 0.36 divided by, so 2, so 18.2 into 10 to the 4 of minus 13. So 10 to the 4 of minus 13. So now calculate this value. So finally, so calculate this value. So the answer is, so this is the joule. So this is measured in joule. So what, 1 electron goes is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the 4 of minus 19 joule. But 1 joule is equal to 1 electron goes divided by 1.6 into 10 to the 4 of minus 19. So that substitute the value. So 2.56 into 10 to the 4 of minus 38, 0.4356 into 0.36 divided by, so 80.2 into 10 to the 4 of minus 31. But 1 joule is equal to, so this is the electron goes to 1.6 into 10 to the 4 of minus 50. So calculation of this value, so then final answer K is equal to 7 mega electron volts. So this is the right option. K is equal to 7 mega electron volts. So once observe the options, option A 9 mega electron volts, option B 10 mega electron volts, option C
7 mega electron volts, option D, 11 mega electron volts. Which is the right option? 7 mega electron volts. Okay. So, next question. So, KCET 2019. Next one. So, KCET 2019. So in a cyclotron, a charged particle is slowed down within a D and the speed up between D's. So which is the right option? Option D. Okay. So next question number 25. Question number 25. The number of turns in a galvanometer is tripled. The number of turns. So that means we know that. So theta by I is equal to MAB divided by C. So this theta by I is called the deflection per unit current. So that is called the current sensitivity. Current sensitivity. So now, so in this both side, so denominator in both side, so divided by R. So that means theta divided by IR is equal to MAB divided by CR. So both sides divided by R. So we know that B is equal to IR. So that implies theta by B, according to Ohm's law, B is equal to IR is equal to. So theta by B is equal to MAB divided by CR. So this is the voltage sensitivity. So this is voltage sensitivity. Okay. So here, so in this problem, so number of turns is tripled. So that means n is equal to 3n. So therefore n is equal to 3n. So we know that r is equal to 3r. So r is equal to 3r because r is directly proportional to n. So r is directly proportional to n. So then substitute n. So theta by I is equal to n. So that is 3n. So A, B divided by C. So that means theta by N is equal to 3NB divided by C. So next we are using voltage sensitivity, theta by B. So N is 3N, AB divided by C into 3R. So that means R is 3 times. So here, we can say that. So that means theta by B is equal to NAB divided by CR. So in this question, so current sensitivity increases by 3 times. Okay, current sensitivity increases by 3 times. But voltage sensitivity remains constant. So current sensitivity increases by 3 times. But voltage sensitivity remains constant. So once observe the options, option A, voltage sensitivity increases 3 times. And the current sensitivity remains constant. So that is wrong. So next B. Voltage sensitivity remains constant and the current sensitivity increases by 3 times. So this is right. Current sensitivity increases by 3 times, but voltage sensitivity remains the constant. So next is C. Both voltage and current sensitivity remains constant. So D, both voltage and current sensitivity increases by 33%. So which is the right option? Option B. So voltage sensitivity remains constant, but current sensitivity increases by 3 times. Okay. So next to question number 26. So next to question number 26. So a circular current loop of magnetic moment M is in a orbitary orientation in an uniform magnetic field. The work done to rotate the help loop by 30 degree about an axis perpendicular to its plane. Okay, so this is the question. A circular current loop. So this is the circular current loop. okay ma, this is the circular current flow, magnetic moment is young, so it is orbitally orientation. So in a uniform magnetic field, so this is the uniform magnetic field, so this is the center. Okay, so the work done to rotate the loop, so in this loop is rotated by 30 degrees. Okay, so this loop is rotated by 30 degrees. So a circular current loop of magnetic moment is young, so E is in orbitary orientation in a uniform magnetic field B. The work done to rotate the loop by 30 degree about an axis perpendicular to its plane. So that means magnetic moment is perpendicular to its plane. So we know that what is the formula for energy? So U is equal to m bar dot v bar. So U is equal to m v cos theta. So here magnetic moment is perpendicular to uniform magnetic field. So magnetic moment is perpendicular to uniform magnetic field. So theta is equal to 90. So cos 90 degree is 0. So therefore U is equal to 0. So now find out work done. So therefore work done is equal to change in potential energy. So here potential energy is 0. So therefore work done is also 0. So therefore work done is equal to 0. So this is the right option. Okay. So once observe the options, option A, MV. Option B, root 3 MV by 2. Option C, MV by 2. Option D, 0. So which is the right option? 0. So 0 is the right option. Okay. So next question. Question number 27. Question number 27. So the magnetic field at the center O in the given figure is, this is the, so question number 27, the magnetic field at the center O in the given figure. So here by using the formula of magnetic field is mu is equal to, so mu naught I divided by, so 4 pi r into d. So here by using this formula, so B is equal to mu naught I divided by 4 pi r into theta. So here this is the angle 60 degree. So remaining this angle is 2 pi minus 60 degree. So now if you use this one, okay, so this one. So what is the magnetic field at the center O in the figure? So by using this angle. So therefore magnetic field B is equal to mu naught I divided by 4 pi r into theta. So theta is, so 2 pi minus 60 degree. So this is equal to mu naught I divided by, so 4 r into 2 pi minus 5 by 3. Okay, so that is equal to mu naught I by, so 4 pi r into, so 6 pi minus 5 by 3. Okay, so this is equal to mu naught I, so 3 4 ja 12 pi into r, 6 pi minus 5 into 5 pi, so pi pi gets cancelled, that is equal to 5 by 12 into mu naught I by r. So this is the magnetic field at the center. So B is equal to 5 by 12 into mu naught I by r. So once observe the options, option A 7 by 14 mu naught I by r, so option B 5 by 12 mu naught I by r, option C 3 by 10 mu naught I by r, option D mu naught I by 12. So which is the right option? So B is equal to 5 by 12 mu naught I by r. So this is the right option. So option number B. Okay. So these questions are corresponding to KCET 2019. Next level, KCET 2020. So next question number 28. So the magnetic field at the origin due to a current element IDL placed at a point with a vector position r bar is, okay, the magnetic field at the origin due to a current element IDL placed at a point with a position vector.
So for example, so this is the origin point. So origin point is the r distance between. So we will take the ideal vector. So now find out the magnetic field in this position. So we know that so B is equal to mu naught by 4 pi. So I into dl vector cross r vector divided by r. So this is the formula for magnetic field. So now the magnetic field at the origin. So in this case, origin. Due to current element. So here, so position vector r is in this direction. R is in. So this is ideal. So now this is the r bar. So this is also r. So here b is equal to mu naught I divided by 4 pi into dl cross minus r divided by r. So this is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi. So r bar cross dl bar divided by r. So here this is reverse. So here minus r. So this is r. Okay. So which is the right option? B is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi into r vector cross dl vector divided by r cube. So the magnetic field at the origin. So magnetic field at the origin due to a current element. Place at a point with a position vector r. So b is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi into r bar plus dl bar divided by r. Okay. So this is the right option. So once observe the options. Option A, mu naught I by 4 pi dl vector plus r vector divided by r square. So that is wrong. Option B, mu naught I by 4 pi r plus dl vector by r square. That is also wrong. Option C. Mu naught by 4 pi dl cross r by r cube. So that is also wrong. So option D, mu naught I by 4 pi r vector cross dl vector divided by r cube. So this is the right option. Option 4, D. So next to question number 29. So two long straight parallel wires are a distance 2D apart. They carry steady equal currents. The following out of the plane of the paper. So the variation of magnetic field along the line. So x x dash is given by. So here magnetic field is inversely proportional to R. So here we take the two straight parallel wires. So this is one wire. This is the another wire. Okay. So this is parallel straight wire. So like this. So this is also parallel straight wire. Okay. So this is parallel straight wire. So this is the center. Okay. So here distance D. Here also distance D. Okay. So this is A. So this is B. Okay. So this is the so XX dash. This is x dash. X dash. So this is the center. So here magnetic field at point. So magnetic field at point would be A. So this is opposite. So here magnetic field at point. So magnetic field at point in this point would be this one. So this is opposite. So they can be formed the graph is like this. They can be formed the graph is like this function. Okay, so upwards, downwards. So next, B is inversely proportional to R. So here, inversely proportional, they can be formed the graph like this. Okay, so this is the nature of the graph. So in four options, which is the right option? Option D is right. Okay, so next, question number 30. Question number 30. So in the given figure, the magnetic field at O. So in the given figure, the magnetic field at O. So in the given figure, the magnetic field at O. So this is the R. So this is R. So this is O. So here possibility of current. So like this. So this is the current. Here also passing through the current. So in this diagram, it can be divided into the first one, two, this is three. So this line is along the center of the axis. Here magnetic field B is equal to B1 plus B2 plus B3. 1, 2, 3. So here 3 points. So magnetic field, so along the center, so along the center is there, magnetic field is 0. So now if we take the arc, so this is the arc. Okay, so here arc. So by using the formula is, so mu naught I by 2R. So mu naught I by 2R into, so your total circle only now 3 by 4 circle is now. So that goes for into 3 by 4. So next plus, so this is the value of B2. So here, this is the center of the circle. What is the formula of mu naught I by 2R? So this is center of the circle. So center of the circle formula will be current carrying A. So current carrying a loop at the center, magnetic field due to current carrying a loop. So along the axis there is the outer edge, the center and outer edge. So center. So what is the value? Mu naught I by 2R into, now total circle only 3 by 4 of the circle used now. And of course mu naught I by 2R into 3 by 4. So next plus B3. So this current, this is the wire. So this wire is perpendicular to this one. Perpendicular to this one, clear angle is 90 degree. So what is the equation? So mu naught I divided by 4 pi r. So mu naught I by 4 pi r. Okay, so here by using capital I, so this is I, this is I. So here V1 is equal to 0. So here value is, so mu naught I, so that means 3. So 3 by, so here 3. Divided by 2 4 the 8, 3 by 8, so mu naught I by 2R plus, so mu naught I divided by 4 pi R. So this is the right option. So here smaller is given. So therefore you can also use for smaller. So then capital portal and capital is more, smaller portal and smaller. So here smaller is given. So now also use for smaller. So 3 by 8, mu naught I by 2R. Mu naught I by 2R also. So this is R. So mu naught, so 2, 4, 8, mu naught I by R. So mu naught I by R plus mu naught I by 4 by R. So this is the right option. 3 by 8 into mu naught I by R plus mu naught I by 4 by R. So once observe the options, option A, 3 by 8, mu naught I by R plus mu naught I by 4 pi r. Option A is right. So next option B, 3 by 8 mu naught I by r minus mu naught I by 4 pi r. So that is wrong. Next option C, 3 by 4 mu naught I by r plus mu naught I by 4 pi r. So option D, so 3 by 4 mu naught I by r plus mu naught I by 4 pi r. So which is the right option? Option A. So next question number 31. Next question number 31. Question number 31. So a long cylindrical wire of radius R carrying a uniform current. So this is the long cylindrical wire. So this is carrying a current. So here R is the radius. Okay. So I flowing through the current. So this is the current flowing, uniform current. Okay, I. The variation of the magnetic field in the distance or on the axis of the wire is given by. So here by using the graph. So B versus R. So in this case, so this is the, so inverse. So inverse B is directly proportional to R on the surface. Small r is equal to capital R. So next, outwards the surface, so B is inversely proportional to R. So this is the right graph in the case of the cylindrical wire. Okay, so B versus R graph is like this. Okay, so here which is the right option? Option A is right. Okay. So next one, question number 32. Question number 32. Question number 32. So a cyclotron is used to accelerate protons. So 1H1 deuteron, 1H2 and alpha particle helium 224. While exciting under similar conditions, the minimum kinetic energy is gained by it. So the minimum kinetic energy. Okay, ma'am. So kinetic energy formula K is equal to U square B square R square divided by 2m. So Q square B square R square divided by 2m. So in this equation, K is inversely proportional to B square divided by 2m. Okay, so first of all, if we take the proton, so that means charge Q is equal to E. So mass M is equal to, so mass of the proton. So that is equal to 1.67 into 10 to the 4 of minus 27 kg. So now find out the kinetic energy of the proton is directly inversely proportional to E square divided by 2m into B. Okay. So this is the proton. So next if we take the deuteron. So deuteron charge is 1, so mass is 2, so 2mv. So but kinetic energy is inversely directly proportional to E. This is E. E square divided by 2 into mv. So 2 into mv. Remember 2 into mv. 2 into mv. This is the M. So next, so if we take the alpha particle, so helium 224, so charge Q is equal to 2E, so mass M is equal to 4MP. So kinetic energy is directly proportional to 4E square divided by 4MP. So here 4 cancel. So K is alpha particle is inversely proportional to E square by M. Okay, no? So here, so we are there. So Q B square R square, B R Q is constant. So therefore, K is directly, so K is proportional to Q square by F. So KB is E square divided by MP. Okay. So deuteron charges to E, mass is to 2MP. So now substitute this equation. So E mass 2MP. So E square divided by 2MP. So next helium 224, that means alpha particle, charge is 2e, so mass is 4m. So now substitute value e square, that means 2e square, so that is 4e square, so divided by m, so 4mp. So mm is cancelled, k alpha is proportional to e square by mp. So now, so kinetic energy of the proton and the kinetic energy of the alpha particle is same. So here kb is directly, kb is proportional to e square by mp. So K alpha is proportional to E square by MP. But deuteron, so KB, so deuteron, so KD is proportional to E square divided by 2MP. So you got 2 and the more than the denominator only. So it is just than the dynamic conduit. So which is the minimum kinetic energy having these three particles? Deuteron. So deuteron having the minimum kinetic energy. So you have to say with them. So you value anything conduit. Denominator only just value that the total value only the value correct. So it is same kinetic energy. So now our aim is minimum kinetic energy and find point. So these three particles, which particle having the minimum kinetic energy? Deuteron. So deuteron having the minimum kinetic energy. So once observe the options, option A deuteron, option B same for all, option C alpha particle, option D proton. So which is the right option? Option A. So next one, question number 33. So this is the last question. Question number 33. So the ratio of the magnetic field at the center of a current carrying a copper coil. So the ratio of magnetic field at the center of a current carrying a copper coil to magnetic moment x. Okay. So we know that, so what is the formula for magnetic field due to current carrying a coil is at center. So BC is equal to mu naught I by 2R. So we know that what is the formula for magnetic moment. So M is equal to IA. So then the ratio of the magnetic field at the center of the current carrying a coil and the magnetic moment is equal to X. is equal to x. So if it's equal to I m, now if you use the current carrying a circle of I m, so what is the area of the coil? I is equal to pi r square. See, the r is the radius. So therefore, area of the circle is pi r square. So according to problem, so current and radius both are double. So current I. So current I is equal to 2 I. So comma radius. So r is equal to 2 r. So r is equal to 2 r. So what happens to the ratio? So here BC. So BC is equal to mu naught I. So 2 I divided by 2 into 2 r. So upon, so next moment, so magnetic moment value is 2 I, so that is 2 I into, so pi into 2 r whole square, so is equal to, so here, so mu naught I, so you have to cancel it again, so this is mu naught I by 2 r, okay, divided by, so 2 square, 2 square means 4, 4 2 is 8, so 8, so I into pi r square, so 8 into I pi r square, so this is equal to, so BC is equal to, what is the value, mu naught I, so mu naught I, so mu naught I divided by 2 r divided by I is equal to pi r square, so this is equal to x. This is equal to x. So this is equal to x. So here by using this one, so 1/8 into, so mu r I divided by 2 r divided by I into pi r square. So mu r I divided by 2 r divided by I pi r square is equal to how much? This value x. So this is equal to x by 8. So now current is doubled, so radius is doubled. So what happens to the new magnetic field? So x divided by 8. So this is the final question. So once observe the option A x by 4, B x by 8, C 2x, D 4x. So which is the right option? X by 8. So this is the last question in this chapter. So thank you. All the best.